So, hope you had time to study the earlier classes, the videos. Any feedback, any questions? Shyam Sundar has not joined. So, Sapna, any questions?
Guruji, I didn't understand the attribute part properly. Is it that the result of whatever we add to the consciousness or
No. See, attribute is a sort of a property. Okay, so let us say you take a mobile phone. So how do you describe a mobile phone? It's square. Okay, it is a yellow color. Right? So you can define, you can describe the properties. These properties are called attributes or adjectives. Now, even if you describe all the property, you are not described the substance. For example, this is a glass. Okay, so even if you say it's round, it has a shining color and all. So this is a glass made up of steel. The properties are not describing the substance. Attributes are describing only the dimension, the color, the shape, form. The substance of this is steel, right? The substance of anything in the universe is consciousness. What we are able to see and experience is only attribute. The consciousness you cannot experience because you are the consciousness. So attribute is what you can feel, touch, and think, what mind can conceive, their properties, whereas the substance of anything is consciousness. Everything is made, like every, all go, ornament of gold, ornaments are made up of gold. Gold is the substance. The, what you call as, the shape, the form of necklace, chain, their attributes. Rajini is joining. Rajini has not joined. And Sheetal.
Thank you, Guruji.
Okay, welcome.
So, Guruji, when you say substance, it means essence, right?
Essence.
Thank you.
Essence and substance means same thing. Yes, Sheetal, did you study the videos? Any questions are there?
Namaste,
Namaste.
Namaste Gurudeva. I studied the first video, that is the ego consciousness, as well as the second one I have studied. The third one I was not able to go through this week. So there were, as you know, there were a couple of things going on. So right now I'm planning to complete this three and the coming one in the coming
Okay.
week. So I'm pretty much clear about most of the things, Gurudeva, the first and the second video. It was very, very clear because, you know, most of the things were so clearly told, I mean, twice or thrice that they seemed very clear to me.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So nobody has to be worried that you are not able to complete the syllabus. You can join repeater course. There's no, it's a, you can get admission any number of time. There's no pass and failure. Okay. So Pratibha Rayan Prashna Idya, any questions?
ಇನ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಓದ್ಬೇಕು, ಹಬ್ಬ ಇತ್ತು, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಬಿಸಿ ಇದ್ವಿ.
ಓಕೆ
ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವೀಕ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ನಾನು ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ.
ಓಕೆ. ಸೊ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ವೈಷ್ಣವಿ, ವೈಷ್ಣವಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ
ಸುಜಯ,
ಸುಜಯ
ಮೂರು ಮಾಡಿದೀನಿ, ಕಳಿಸಿದ್ದೀನಿ,
ನೋಡಿದೆ,
ನೋಡಿದೀರಾ?
ಏನಾದ್ರು ಪ್ರಶ್ನೆಗಳಿದೆಯಾ?
ಒಂದು ಅದು ಅಹಂಕಾರ ನೆನಪಿನಿಂದ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಿರಲ್ಲ,
ಹೌದು,
ಹೇಗೆ ನೆನಪು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನು ಅಲ್ಲಿ?
ನೀವು ನಾನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ, ಓಕೆ, ನಾನು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದಾಗ
ಇಂಗ್ಲಿಷ್ನಲ್ಲೇ ಹೇಳಿ ಪರವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ.
ಓಕೆ, ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಐ, ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಐ ಇಸ್ ಐ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್, ದ ರೆಕಗ್ನಿಷನ್ ಐ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್. ಮೈ ವೆನ್ ಐ ವೇಕ್ ಅಪ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಾರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್, ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್? ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಎಕ್ಸಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಫೀಲಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಆರ್ ದ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಐ ಮೆಟ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್, ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ಈಸ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಆಫ್ ಮೈ ಫ್ರೆಂಡ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಅಸೋಸಿಯೇಟ್ ದ ಮೆಮರಿ ಮೈ ಮೈಂಡ್, ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಫ್ಯೂಚರ್, ರೈಟ್? ವೆನ್ ಯು ಸೇ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಸುಜಯ, ಸೊ ಯು ಆರ್ ಸೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೊಫೆಸರ್, ಐ ಟಾಟ್ ಸಂಸ್ಕ್ರಿಟ್, ಸೊ ದ ಆಲ್ ದೋಸ್ ಮೆಮರೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್. ಸೊ ದ ಅಹಂಕಾರ ಅಟ್ಯಾಚಸ್ ಟು ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೈಂಡ್.
Memory means, I thought it comes from samskara.
No, memories, there's a recording in the memory.
Okay.
Right? So the I am, the ego, identifies with the memory or the body or the mind or the body. It identifies. I am the body is identification. I am Sujaya, I am teaching Sanskrit is a memory identification.
In this, ee janma the memory ne varodu.
Ha.
Not from previous janmas.
Previous janma varodu samskara, memory ili bandirutade. It will be stored in memory. But identity comes with the ego. Okay. Ego will identify with that.
Okay.
Memory can come from previous samskara also, memory. But identity happens with the, by the ego. I'll identify with that.
Yes.
Right?
Okay, I understand.
Ownership. It takes the ownership of memory. Oh, this is my memory.
From past tense only, it takes the memory.
Correct. Okay. Ego survives on memory. So, Lata, did you study the videos? Any questions?
No, Prabhu. I did not.
I mean, you didn't study or no questions? Which is the answer?
Because I did not study, there are no questions.
Okay.
ಆಮೇಲೆ ಜೀವನಿಗೆ ವಿಶೇಷಣ, ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು ವಿಶೇಷಣ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೆ.
ಹೀಗೆ
ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಇದು ಅಜ್ಞಾನ ಅಲ್ವಾ?
ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಅವಿದ್ಯಾ ಅಜ್ಞಾನ. ಹಲೋ, ಎಸ್, ಹೌದು, ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಏನಮ್ಮ? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅವಿದ್ಯ?
ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್, ಐ ಮೀನ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್.
ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅಜ್ಞಾನ?
ಇಗ್ನೋರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಅಲ್ವಾ?
ಸೇಮ್. ವಿಶೇಷಣ,
ವಿಶೇಷಣ ಹೇಗಾಗುತ್ತೆ?
ವಿಶೇಷಣ ಮೀನ್ಸ್
ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ.
ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ, ರೈಟ್?
Yes,
it is not a natural prop, it is not natural to jiva.
Yes.
Okay, ajnana can be dropped, still jiva, nothing happens to jiva, jiva becomes sakshi.
Right.
So what is added as a qualification? For example, let us say you are MA in Sanskrit. MA is Sanskrit vicheshana.
Yes.
Qualification. So MA in Sanskrit is removed. What will happen to you? Still you are there.
Yeah.
So jiva, adnana or avidya is visheshana. If you remove the visheshana also, jiva is there. Right? It's not an essential property. The necessary quality of jiva is sat chit ananda only. Sat chit ananda remove madre jiva illa. Right? Okay, shall we continue? Yes.
Hello, Prabhuji.
Did you study any of the videos?
No, I am new to this video.
Oh, okay.
So, Prabhuji, you say because of the vasana samskaras, we get new births, right?
Uh-huh.
So, what I have understood is the first birth, whatever happened, was for consciousness to witness everything. True?
Yes.
To experience its own self.
Yes.
But is it not like consciousness is there? Unless we realize consciousness, we can get out of the trap of the game.
Correct.
So it's like a self-learning thing, right?
Yes.
It comes, it takes various forms, it knows itself, it gets out.
Correct.
Okay. So what is the use of Maya? Is it just there, or is there any reason behind it?
It's for experiencing, playing, learning. Why do you play video games? Why do you go to movies?
To experience.
That's all. Okay, Lata, I am starting the triplet prakriya. Okay, let's start on prakriya. Vijay, you have any questions?
No, Guruji. I've completed till 20. So far, no questions, Guruji.
Okay, is it becoming too tough or too heavy for all the people to do study the video, understand and complete it? Is there any challenge in that?
Yes, Gurudeva, I have something to speak about this. As I was, whenever I used to, write things, I used to cover a lot of things because the writing was happening and I was able to assimilate a lot. I was able to grasp a lot. Now okay. That, this, when we are talking in the video, okay, I feel that the information which I am delivering is very small and concise. And Gurudeva, I am not someone who would like to get into the small thing. I don't want it to be small. I think it can be
What I'm saying is you do whatever is comfortable for you.
Yes, because writing is my way of expression. Okay. And I don't say that I can't speak, but
I'm saying you're right.
Yeah.
And if you want, you can write and speak also.
I have no problem. Okay, Gurudeva. Sure. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Okay.
It gives me my freedom of expression, basically.
Yeah, yeah. Thank you. Otherwise, tomorrow we'll have some women's right liberation, women's movement, freedom of expression speak out. Why should I get into all this trouble? No, all the right. Whatever you want to do.
No, Gurudeva. Yes. No, nothing, Gurudeva, nothing of that sort. Thank you, Gurudeva. Thank you.
Hari Om, Prabhuji.
Hari Om, where are you?
Prabhuji, I am here.
Not able to see.
Prabhuji, it's like, I think it's Shailaja Narayana.
Okay. Yeah. So, how are you? Any questions?
I have one question, Prabhuji. Why has Ramana Maharshi told so many things about self-enquiry? Did he have a mission of any self-enquiry or what? Did he have some mission related to self-enquiry, Vicharamarg or what? Did he have a mission of... mission related to self-enquiry?
Mission, you mean? You mean mission?
Yeah. Like your mission is Gargar Gurukul. Like.
So Ramana Maharshi didn't have any mission. Okay. Right. Mission. Say there is a difference between vision and mission. Right. Okay. What is the difference between vision and vision? Vision is what I would like to have, like
in the future.
Future, right? So my mission is not Gargar Gurukul. My vision is Gargar Gurukul.
Okay.
Mission means I'll build our nation. I'll build so many build this thing. Then I'll do something about it, right?
Is it MISSION, your Gargar Gurukul, or VISION?
VISION, vision.
Okay.
Okay. Mission is this my vision. So if you want to take that vision and convert into mission, it's your mission.
Okay.
Mission means I'll do something about it. Vision means I'll create a picture about it.
Okay. Then even did Ramana Maharshi have Gargar Gurukul, and did it come from Ajja?
No, no, he didn't have any mission or vision. Okay. Ramana Maharshi just, when people came and asked him the question, he just answered. That's all.
Okay.
He didn't have any vision or mission.
Okay.
I just describe in terms of vision. Okay. It is not that it's not like a mission. Is that okay? This is what should happen. That's what I feel.
Prabhuji, did Ramana Maharshi have great interest in Atma Jnana, but how Shankaracharya had a great interest in Advaita Vedanta?
See, Shankaracharya and Ramana Maharshi are different. Okay.
Yeah.
So Shankaracharya is an Acharya.
Okay.
What is the meaning of Acharya is somebody who is a teacher.
Yeah.
Okay. So he has to write a syllabus, he has to write a book, and he has to teach people.
Yeah.
Okay. He Whereas
he has to create something which helps the society.
Yes, he has to create something, right? Ramana Maharshi is not an Acharya. He does not have a syllabus. He does not have anything to write. He does not have any books. He is a saint, Jnani. So if people come and ask him some question, he will give answer. That's all.
Okay.
Are you clear?
Yeah. Prabhuji, have you asked any questions to Ramana Maharshi?
I have never met Ramana Maharshi.
Ramana
Maharshi passed away long back.
Okay. About that, some surgery you had told hands.
Yeah.
He was very conscious, you told in one of the video.
Correct. So, any more questions? Shall we start?
Prabhuji,
are you able to see everybody? You're able to see? Right, okay. So, this is called Darpana Prakriya. Darpana means mirror. Okay. Prakriya means a process. A prakriya is a process of teaching the Vedanta or Atma Jnana. So Darpana Prakriya, first let us understand. Okay. So let us imagine that you are sitting in a rocket and going in outer space. And there is a sun behind you. And if you look from the window, what will you see? Will you see darkness or light? Actually, you'll see complete darkness. There'll be no light. Because the sunlight cannot be seen by the naked eyes. Sunlight requires a reflecting surface. In the outer space, there's no reflecting surface. Because there's no reflecting surface, if you see outside the window, you'll see only darkness. So in Earth, you'll see the sunlight, Because the sunlight falls on the dust particles in the air and it gets reflected. That's why we see reflected light. Consciousness is similar, something similar to that. The consciousness of Chaitanyam or the Atma is all pervading. There's no way we can experience it or see it. To see the consciousness or experience the consciousness, it needs a reflecting surface. It needs a surface to reflect. Without the reflecting surface, this consciousness cannot be seen. So the reflecting surface is the object of the world, Maya. So somebody asked the question, why Maya is there? Because the consciousness presence can be seen only in the presence of Maya. Maya is the reflecting surface. Only then we can understand there is a consciousness. So the consciousness is Chetana and the world is matter, object, is Jada. So when the Chaitanya, the consciousness falls on the matter, Jada, there's a reflection. In the reflection, we can see the presence of the consciousness. Otherwise, you cannot know the consciousness is there. So matter, what we can see as a matter, what we call as matter, physical matter, has form. Form includes touch, sound, smell, taste, and feel. So these are the forms of the matter. Consciousness has no form. When the consciousness gets reflected on the matter, you become conscious of that form. Just like sunlight, sun, presence of sun is known only if there is a reflection of sunlight on an object. The consciousness is known only when the object is present. That object becomes a reflecting surface for the consciousness. So let us take what we call as Sakshi or the consciousness. Sakshi is the inner self. Sakshi is what I am. Brahman is the universal consciousness. Sakshi and Brahman are one and the same. So the light of the Sakshi gets reflected on the mind. The mind is the mirror. Mind becomes the reflection, reflecting surface, mirror. And the secondary reflection of the mind falls on the body, and third reflection falls on the world. The sun represents the Sakshi, the witness. So the primary reflection is the mind. The mind I have shown as a mirror. The consciousness gets reflected here. So the mind becomes alive. Then there is a feeling of I am. So this is exactly what happens when you wake up in the morning. In deep sleep, there is no mind. Only consciousness is there. When you wake up, the mind comes up. There's a reflection called I am in the mind. So then the reflection of that falls on the body, secondary reflection. Then the body appears. So then through sense organs get illuminated, and through sense organs, reflection falls on the world. So the world appears. The first reflection is the mind, second reflection is the body, and third reflection is the world. So, body becomes alive, and the consciousness, awareness falls on the world through the sense organs. So reflection is only one, chidabhasa. The reflected light makes body alive, otherwise body is dead matter, body is inert. And senses become alive, and through senses, the awareness flows into the world. Right? So now, this reflection on the mind is called Chidabhasa. So the mind plus Chidabhasa, the reflecting surface and the consciousness which is reflecting that is called jiva, which is you. So the jiva is a combination of reflecting surface and the reflection. See, you cannot separate out the reflection from the mirror. If your face is there in the mirror, you cannot separate out the face from the mirror. They are one. Like that, jiva becomes one with the mind. The chaitanya, the consciousness, reflected consciousness becomes one with the mind. Okay. So now the challenge of spirituality is the chidabhasa, reflected consciousness, has to understand I am really sakshi. And sakshi is Brahman. This understanding has to happen. Otherwise, it will identify with the reflection, mirror. Whatever is happening in the mirror, it starts thinking it's happening in me. So the mirror shows the body, mirror shows the world. So the chidabhasa also gets associated with body and says, I am the body. Now, how do you stop this reflection? You have to break the mirror. Breaking the mirror is not a solution. You cannot break the mirror because you cannot break the mind. So that's where the importance of buddhi, intellect. Using your intellect, you have to separate out what is consciousness and what is matter. What is chidabhasa and what is matter? What is chaitanyam? What is matter? This is called viveka. Intellect only. Buddhi. Mind, buddhi. Mirror is the buddhi, intellect. So using your intellect only, sharpened intellect, you have to separate out what is matter and what is consciousness. This is called Atma Anatma Viveka. So for example, the jiva sees the body and says, I am the body. So Atma Anatma Viveka is okay. You have to inquire, is body really consciousness? Body is inert because body I can see. So I am consciousness, I am Sakshi, you have to think. So then the intellect, the thoughts are there in the mind. So the thoughts are changing constantly. So, but I don't change, I am doesn't change. That's why I am Sakshi, thoughts are not me. Like that you have to discriminate using the intellect. In this way, you can separate out reflection from the mirror. This is the only way you can separate out reflection from the mirror logically, not physically. Okay. So what some people do is stop the thoughts in the mind. That means make the mind blank. That means there is no mirror. So then chidabhasa has merged with the consciousness, but there's no learning. Understanding has not happened in the intellect. So for the understanding to happen, you have to use the discrimination. What I am not, what I am not, what I am not. Neti, neti, neti. Yeah, they're shedding the mind. Okay, so this discrimination is what makes a difference. So this I call it as mirror prakriya, or prakriya means a process. So you can think everything is a mirror for the consciousness. Okay, so when I see the world is a mirror for consciousness because it's reflecting the consciousness. Everything in the world is reflecting consciousness. Okay, for example, when I see sun, I'm seeing the consciousness reflect on the sun, awareness. My awareness is falling on the sun. Through my eyes, awareness goes, or consciousness goes and falls on the sun. So I have sun consciousness. So when I see sun, it is sun consciousness. When I see the moon, it's a moon consciousness. When I see the flower, flower consciousness. So every object in the world becomes a mirror for consciousness. So as long as you understand it's a mirror, so you say this is a mirror and I am consciousness. But if you forget that it's a mirror, you start giving importance to the object. You give importance to the mirror. So you have to separate out the reflection from the mirror. Every object in the world is a mirror for consciousness. The world is a mirror for consciousness. Atma.
Guruji.
Yes.
If the same consciousness is reflecting on every object, then why is the objects different? Like, why does it look different for us?
Yeah, I'll tell you why the objects are different, right? So the consciousness is same, but through instrument through which the reflection takes place is different. Eyes. Okay. See, the eyes are sensing, eyes are organs for sensing. Okay. So when I sense through the eyes, the object has some certain shape. Okay. So now here we are not asking whether the object has, there is a called object or not. There is an object outside which has a form. Because I see through the eyes, or I sense to the touch, I get a different experience. So when I say reflection, I am seeing through the eyes, the consciousness is reflecting the object, I sense through the eyes. Different sense organs define what I see, what I experience. Okay. So now, for your question, why there are different objects there out there, Shiva? In your dream, in your deep sleep, there are no objects. But in your dream, you see a forest, a tree, and everything. Correct? So where did this forest come? Where did this tree come from? Where did the tiger in the forest came from? They are projected by the mind. Okay, they are there in your memory, impression. Similarly, the world of objects is there in the impression of the universal consciousness. They are projected and experienced through sense organs. Because they are objects which are present in the universal consciousness, they have different objects and different forms. And when you see through the eyes, you see the reflected consciousness. Does that answer your question, Shiva?
Yes, Guruji.
Okay.
Guruji, is it like the electricity that flows? The electricity is same, but then it can be like in the fan, it can spin around, or light, it will give light bulb. So is it like that?
There are two analogies here. First analogy is in dream, okay, when you are dreaming, the dream world is projected, right? Why there is a world outside? Because in your dream, let's say forest is there, tree is there, everything is there. So where did the forest come from? It is there in your memory. It got projected during the dream. Mind, what was there in the memory, got projected, and you are experiencing it. There's a projection and experiencing, correct? There's no forest or tree outside. There's a projection happening with the mind, and experiencing happening through the mind. So similarly, there's no world outside. Okay, whatever the world outside is there is a projection by the mind, not the universal mind. And you are experiencing that projection in the form of Bangalore, city, your house, your family. What exactly happens in the dream state happens in the waking state also. Right? But when the object is there, okay, the object is seen because there's a reflected consciousness there, Chidabhasa. For example, let's take my hand, okay? So is light in front of my eyes? There's light, but my eyes cannot see the light without a blocking. The blocking. So if I put my hand, I can see my hand. In reality, I'm not seeing the hand, I'm seeing the reflected light on the hand. Okay? But I forget the reflected light and think the importance of the hand. Similarly, am I seeing the reflected light on the hand? In reality, awareness is coming, awareness or consciousness is flowing from my eyes, reflecting on the hand and the light, and I'm seeing that. Actually, I'm seeing the reflected consciousness on my hand.
Yeah.
When I see the flower, I'm seeing flower consciousness. When I see the tree, I'm seeing tree consciousness, right? The tree is just a name and form. And how did the name and form come? Because of projection by the mind. So the consciousness is Brahman. Whatever I am seeing in the world, actually I am seeing Brahman only. And Brahman is myself. I am seeing myself in the form of tree. I am seeing myself in the form of sun. I am seeing myself in the form of a building. So let us take the dream analogy again.
In the Prabhuji, one question.
I'll just complete then ask the question. Okay. In my dream, I see a tiger. Actually, I am seeing myself in the form of tiger. In reality, in dream, I am seeing a tree. In reality, I am seeing myself in the form of tree in the dream. Similarly, the waking state, whatever I am seeing myself in various forms. Atma alone is not a physical body, Prabhu, the consciousness, Atma. Atma itself is seen in various forms. So in other words, only God alone is there, Brahman alone is there, within and without. So this is called darpana prakriya, because you have to remember everything is a mirror. And I give some practical examples. Okay. If you see your boss, you'll get tensed up. Remember, boss is nothing but a mirror for your consciousness. And smile. In front of the mirror, you're supposed to smile. Remember, you look at your husband and remember that husband is nothing but a reflection mirror for you. Reflection for consciousness. Look at your wife, and wife is nothing but mirror for consciousness, mirror for you. Everywhere you are seeing yourself in the reflection, as reflection. Self means Atma, which is Chaitanyam, which is consciousness. So is this understanding clear?
Gurudeva?
Yes.
Gurudeva, the Sakshi is the one which is throwing light on the Chidabhasa. That is mirror. That is Chidabhasa, and Jiva is the mirror.
No, mind is the mirror. Mind is the mirror. Buddhi, intellect is the mirror. Intellect, Buddhi is the mirror.
Buddhi is the mirror. So by you, as you said, by using a discrimination, where is the discrimination in the mirror only?
Okay. So first let's say Sakshi is the light. Sakshi is the sun, right? I showed the sun. Sakshi is the light. Sakshi is the self, Atma. From the Sakshi, the light of the self comes, Atma Jyoti. Awareness spreads. So the awareness cannot see. Awareness needs a reflecting surface. This is the buddhi,
yes.
Intellect. The moment awareness, the light of the self falls on Atma Jyoti, on the mirror called mind or buddhi, there's a reflection. The reflection is called Chidabhasa.
Okay.
Okay. Reflected light is called Chidabhasa. Yes. A sun is there. Reflection of sun is there in the water. Okay. The reflection is called Chidabhasa. Like reflection of Sakshi in the mind, Chidabhasa.
Yes. Now,
can you separate out the reflection from the mirror?
No.
No, no?
Yeah.
You cannot do. Because reflection can exist if there's a mirror. If there's no mirror, there's no reflection.
Yes.
Right? The entire, the reflection now, Chidabhasa, is also intelligent because it comes from Sakshi. The reflection also, reflection of sun has the properties of sun only. The bright.
Yes.
Right? So reflection of Sakshi has also properties of Sakshi. Intelligence. But the reflection does not know I am the reflection. Reflection identifies with the mirror. Anything happening in the mirror, it says it is happening to me. Right?
Yeah.
Let us say, for example, there's a pain in the body. There's a pain. The body, a body has a reflection, chidabhasa. So there, oh, chidabhasa feels, I have a pain. I am in pain. It identifies with the body rather than the atma. The sun.
Yes.
Correct?
Yeah.
Now, how to remove this reflection? You want liberation. Liberation associated with the body or mind. Then mirror. Which is breaking the mirror is not possible.
Yes.
In deep sleep, the mirror is not there. In deep sleep, mind is not there.
Yes.
That's why there's no reflection. At that time, Jiva has merged with the Atma, Sakshi only. In deep sleep.
Yes.
Right? All in sleep. But in the waking state, we logically understand what's happening, logically, with Jnana. Then we should separate out. Discrimination you have to do. How you have to do discrimination? Chidabhasa and Buddhi, they are one unit. That's called Jiva.
Okay.
Right? They have become one unit.
Yes.
Now the Chidabhasa will use the Buddhi, intellect, to discriminate. Okay, who am I? Who am I not? Right? It'll say, okay, I am able to see the world. I'm not the world. World is my mirror. I'm seeing the reflection in the world. So it will say, okay, am I able to feel the body? Yes. So body is the mirror. I am seeing the reflection, chidabhasa. So can I see the thought? Yes. The thoughts are not me. Neti. I am the sakshi. Like that you have to separate logically.
Gurudeva, this logic, now you are giving us the logic. That is, did we have this logic or now the guru is giving the logic, we are taking it from you?
You had right? All magic in your life, no logic at all. So your life learned magic, right? The day you are born, in within 15 days, you have learned that you are Sheetal.
Yeah.
And you learned that you are a girl. Okay, then you learned that you have to get married. So you have children. So whole of logic, whole wrong logic you learn from the society, on the right logic can be given by Vedanta and Guru.
Yes. So the intelligence, that is the logic, the buddhi is already a part of Chidabhasa because it is already given through the Sakshi as Chidabhasa.
No. Intellect is there. Intellect is a matter. It's the reflecting surface. Chidabhasa is the reflection.
Yes.
This reflecting surface, reflection becomes one unit. Logically, separate. This logical separation is called viveka, discrimination.
Yeah, this viveka is there in the sakshi only?
No.
From where is...
Chidabhasa is reflection of sakshi, no? Chidabhasa has become one with the mind. The mind is
yes.
Right? That instrument has to be properly used by Chidabhasa to understand I am sakshi.
So that viveka is there in Chidabhasa only. It will use it to know itself.
No. Viveka is not there in Chidabhasa. Viveka is given through the teaching. Viveka is discrimination. How to discriminate?
Okay. So this teaching, what you are giving, it is coming from externally. That is, it is coming from the world, I can say, or what?
It is coming from Upanishad and Guru.
So it is apart from the world.
No, already the world teaching is already there, no? World teaching is already, the intellect is already corrupted, no?
Already there, yes.
It is already corrupted and already you are convinced that you are Sheetal, you are a woman, you behave like this. All that conviction is there, no? That's already given by the world.
Yes.
So you understand you are Atma.
Yes.
How you understand you are a Sakshi? For that, a logic is required. That logic comes from the Vedanta and it comes from the teaching of Guru. So it is nothing but repairing the logic in the intellect, repairing the corruption in the intellect. right? For whom is the teaching? For the Chidavasa, it's the teaching. Intellect is the instrument.
Yes. Yes.
Prabhuji. Prabhuji, is darpana prakriya is darpana prakriya finding the source of the mind?
Darpana prakriya is understanding that everything in the world is a reflecting surface for the chaitanyam, consciousness.
Okay.
When I am seeing anything in the world, actually I say there's a coffee, there's a table, there's a chair. Actually, I am seeing the chaitanyam in the form of table. Okay. I am seeing Atma in the form of table.
Okay. Prabhuji, and one more question. For consciousness, you told the world is very small, but consciousness is infinite, no? Then why is it like you had told in some video, it's just like some image. It's just like some image in the consciousness, you told. But the consciousness is infinite, no, Prabhuji?
Consciousness is definitely infinite. So, what is the question?
Prabhuji, so why is it only a small picture? Why can't it be a big picture? Because this consciousness is infinite.
Consciousness is infinite. You have a big, paper. Does not mean that you have to write a big picture on that. You, whatever picture you write, that's all.
Yeah.
Huh? So, write you write your, you go to your school, no? Question paper you have to write, answer paper you write, no? Right?
Yeah.
The answer, there for five sheets they give. You have to write all the five sheets or two sheets answers are complete, you can write sufficient.
We should complete how much they give totally, we should complete. So that we'll get attempt.
Then there will be another five more sheets empty. So you want to fill up that also?
No, if the question is, if the answer is very big, we'll use those five pages.
No, then still another five pages I'll give you. Will you write there?
No, because it will be, if in five pages also it's not sufficient, we'll use that five pages.
Right. So the world is sufficient for the consciousness to understand itself. It is a small portion, sufficient for that.
Okay.
Guruji.
Yeah.
Prabhuji, is there more presentation or should I stop and again start?
Yeah. Now, question ask anybody else has questions?
Guruji, one nimsha.
Yes, Kathy.
ಈಗ ನೀವು ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ದರ್ಪಣ ಪ್ರಕ್ರಿಯೆ, ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ಈಗ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸದಿಂದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ತೋರಿಸ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಆ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಪ್ರತಿಯೊಂದು ಜೀವಾನು ಒಂದನ್ನು ಒಂದನ್ನು ನೋಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸುಲಭ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಕ್ಕೆ ಅಂತ.
ಅಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ಬೇರೆ ಬೇರೆ ಪ್ರಕ್ರಿಯೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸೋಣ.
ನಾನು ಯಾತಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಈಗ ಶೀತಲ್ ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ, ಈಗ ಗುರು ಅನ್ನೋದು ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಬಂತು, ಹೊರಗಡೆಯಿಂದ ಬಂತ ಟೀಚಿಂಗು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅನ್ನ ತೋರಿಸಿದಾಗ ಒಬ್ರಿಗೊಬ್ರು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಗುರುನು ಆ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲೇ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಸೊ ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಸೊಸೈಟಿಯಿಂದ ಬಂತು ಆ ಜೀವಕ್ಕೆ. ಸೊ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿರೋ ಗುರುವಿಂದ ಮತ್ತೆ ವಿದ್ಯೆ ಬಂತು ಅಂತ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಬಹುದಲ್ವಾ
ಅಂತ. ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. ಸೊ ವಿದ್ಯೆ ಮತ್ತು ಅವಿದ್ಯೆ ಎರಡು
ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ನಿಂದಾನೇ ಬರುತ್ತೆ.
ಅದು
ತನ್ನ ವಾಪಸ್ಸು ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ಚಿದಾಭಾಸಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ.
Ignorance and knowledge.
Thank you.
Ignorance and knowledge.
ಇದೆ ನನಗೆ ಇದೆ.
Ignorance and see, Atma Jnana, both are from the world.
Yes.
Okay.
Now it is very clear. Thank you, Kaityani ji. Thank you, Gurudeva.
Because Atma itself has no bondage and liberation. Right? The bondage and liberation is only in Maya. Both Jnana and Ajnana, both are in Maya.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yes.
If Atma is really bonded, then you cannot get out.
Yes. Now that you were saying that dream analogy, no, I was just about to ask it in a different way when Kathayani ji just clarified this with you. I was about to ask that, see, now I'm in a dream world, I'm dreaming. But to come out of this, there has to be someone who has to tell me that get up, you are asleep, and you are not this, you are not that. So that person will also be in the dream only who will come and awake me.
No, no, person will come into the dream. Person is not in the dream.
he has to come into my dream. So you guru, are coming.
Guru is one who is not in the dream. But Guru appears in the dream.
Yes. So Upanishads, Vedantas are in the, they are appearing in the world, but they are not of the world.
They are not of the world.
Yes. Yes. Yes, okay. Gurudeva. Thank you.
Okay.
Clear.
So, Lata, you can stop this. So this will be about Darpana Prakriya. So, let me ask you a question. When you are born, okay, when you were born, how many children were there born for your parents? We always think that I am only born. So we are not speaking of your brother and sisters. When you were born to your parents, how many children were born? You think you are one child which is born. In reality, there are three children. Can you see? First child is the human child. One cell from your father and one cell from your mother. Okay. Just one cell, your father and mother contributed one cell each. The one cell, the two cells became four cells became eight became 16, and you became a meatball. And the meatball started developing eyes somewhere, ears somewhere, nose somewhere. So you have a first child is the biological child, which is because of your parents, one cell from the mother, one cell from the father. Is it all? The biological child, okay? Biological child has contribution from your parents, only two cells. Imagine, now your body has billions of cells, trillions of cells. Your parents didn't contribute to that. And how proud you feel that I have, it's my child. In your child, for your child, your contribution is only two cells, my dear. And the two has become four has become eight. You didn't do that. 4, 8, 16. Who made that? That is the divine consciousness Shakti, the power of consciousness Shakti, the divine mother. She multiplied two cells into four into eight into 16. And she fixed the eyes at this place, ears at this place, exactly where it is required. So that's why there's a poet called, there's a Sufi saint called Kahil Gibrail. He says, your children are not your children. They are the God's children. You are only providing a passage for the divine children to come to the earth. You are actually a gateway. You have a responsibility for the child, but you cannot own the child because they are God's children. So now you have to ask yourself how many children you have. So this is called human child. Okay, human child is because two cells from the mother, father and mother came into picture. That's called biological child. So then there's a divine child, which is consciousness got reflected there. This is Chidabhasa. The Chidabhasa got reflected in the mind. And once Chidabhasa got reflected, then they start developing the body. The two cells become four. The consciousness, the power of consciousness called Shakti. The intelligence started creating the whole body, building the whole body. So really, the divine mother is responsible for this. The two cells had a reflected consciousness. The reflected consciousness is Shiva. the universal consciousness got reflected as Chidabhasa. Atma got reflected as Chidabhasa in that body. So you are the second child. This is actually the first child. The first child has biological father and biological mother. The second child has divine father and divine mother. The Chidabhasa has the divine father, Atma. Okay, the body, which is actually from 2 cells, it became 4 cells, 8 cells. That's because of the divine mother. So you have divine father and divine mother. In whole of this process, the biological parents only contribute 2 cells. And rest all is the contribution of divine father, divine mother, Shakti and Shiva. So they are divine parents. So then comes the third child. So you can see the hair has grown a little bit. Okay. So now, immediately after 13 days, the child is given a name. Papa, Chinnu, Guddu. Okay. Some name is given to the child. So Papu, Papu. The child doesn't know it is itself. The child is innocent. Okay. So suddenly it gives a name. It doesn't know. Then every day mother comes and programs the child. You are that Papu. You are that Guddu. You are that Chinnu. Gradually the programming takes place. The mind starts growing. So the mind is the third child. Okay. And so there are first child is biological parents, 2 parents, father and mother. And then the divine father and divine mother, Shiva and Shakti. And the third child, which is actually contribution of society, mother, father, grandparents, TV, mobile phone, video games, school classmates, teacher, the school, the society, books, everything, and Puranas, Itihasas, religions, Pujaris, Pandits, everybody will come program this third child, the society child. Okay. So now there are 3 children. You thought you were only one? There are 3. The biological child, the divine child, and the society child. The biological child has only 2 parents. They have just given 2 cells and they think they have done a big job. Okay. And then there's a divine child, divine mother and father who have done all other job. Building up your whole body, giving your eyes, fixing your ears, and then everything. Then the society child does all the spoiling. It programs you. Right? So there are 3 children. Divine child, the society child, and biological child. Now, if I ask you, who are your parents? What will you say? You'll happily say, biological parents. Without knowing that, they have just given you 2 cells. Who are you really in this, out of these? Biological child, societal child, or divine child? What are you really? Okay. You think you are only the biological child. Biological child is just a 2 cells contribution from the parents. Really? You are the divine child, the consciousness, Chidabhasa, and the body built by Shakti. Your biological parents, mother, gives you, feeds you milk couple of months after you are born. After that, you have to eat. Okay. She will carry you for 9 months after her responsibility ends. But the divine mother's responsibility, it doesn't end there. She takes care of you till you die. She will take, your eyes are functioning because of divine energy, Shakti. Your ears are functioning because of divine energy. Your tongue is functioning because of divine Shakti. Your heart is functioning. Your kidney is functioning. Your liver is functioning. You are able to talk, speak. Your brain is functioning. All because of divine mother Shakti. You don't even know how your brain is functioning. You don't know how tongue is talking. Okay. So biological mother job ends. Or rather, she will take care of you. Now biological mother job ends also, even if 35 years also, mama, baby, mama will be there. But that is not there. She doesn't come and take care of you every day. Every second, every minute, when you are waking state or dream state or deep sleep state, The divine mother takes care of you, Shakti. In terms of prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. So five pranas, she takes care of you. The Shiva, the consciousness, divine father guards your consciousness. Chaitanya, Chidabhasa is present in you all the time. So who are you really? But you don't, if you, all the time you are the society child. If I ask you, who are you? You say, I am woman. Who told you are a woman? Because society. Okay, you say, I am wife. That is a society child. All our problems in life are the society child. The society child is the noisemaker. It's a cry baby. All you say, I have a problem. Who has a problem? The society child. And the society child problems are not your problems. These are society problems dumped on you. Okay, you say, I don't look smart. Why? My color skin is not fair. Who told you are not, because fair you are not look good? Society. So all problems of society have become your problem. And in your house, there are three children and they make noise. Who will get the maximum attention? The crying baby gets the maximum attention. My in our house, there are two children, my daughter and my cousin's daughter. Okay, the cousin's daughter is naughty and she'll pinch my daughter and both will cry. Then you don't know who is crying, who is causing problem for whom. Right? So the society child makes big noise and loud noise. So you think that you have a problem. Okay? The divine child is most silent. It is very peaceful. The divine child has no problem. Biological child has some problems. Of course, it wants food, hungry, it will cry. Okay? It wants to do pissing, it has some problem. It has some fever and some diseases. That's the problem of biological child. There are million problems for you, all because of society child. And you think it's all your problem. Who are you really? No, it's imposed, superimposed from divine child. Divine child is silent. So, who are you really? Are you the divine child or society child or biological child? This biological child, okay, see here, the biological child cannot survive without the divine child. The society child cannot survive without the divine child and biological child. So the divine child can survive anyway because they're from divine father and divine mother, consciousness, energy. It doesn't require anybody. So who are you really? Whose problem you are solving in your life? Who? Okay. All your life you are trying to solve the problem of this society child. Do you understand that? And Atma Adnana, all because of the society child. The divine child is always blissful. When the child is born, the child is called God actually. Your parents will say, God. You also say, the child is divine. Because the child comes with the bliss of the self, Atma, Shiva. Shiva is the self. The child has a bliss in his face. That's why anybody sees the child, they feel happy. Joy is there. But after you grow up, you become mess. The bliss is gone. Only mess is there. Why? Because of the society child. Now, entire Atmajnana is understanding that I am not the society child. I am not the biological child. I am the divine child. This understanding and discrimination is called Atmajnana. You don't have to become divine child. You are already divine child. Any questions? Is that clear?
Yes, this is a revision, Guruji. Last class you have done this in February.
You are there in the last. Is this revision for all or is it revision? It is done.
In February class you have done this.
No, Guruji, for us okay. It is no.
Okay, some people are new, okay? So, any questions are there?
it is very good. It is a revision to understand properly.
Okay. Divine child is the Sakshi. Divine child is Chidabhasa. Chidabhasa is the Sakshi, Shiva. So is this clear? So all your problems are not your problems. It's the society problems. Atmajnana and Atmajnana also come from society.
So nice.
Huh? So Guruji, nice. Modi should solve all the problems.
So, Swapna, is it clear?
Yes, Guruji. But one thing, when we are thinking of Atmajnana, we remember that we are a divine child. But when we are completely involved in some other work, we forget. Why is that?
The crying baby gets more attention. The silent baby doesn't get attention. The divine child is a silent baby.
But every time, how do we practice to be a divine child?
So that's why this class is there. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa.
Yeah, we are doing that, Guruji.
Okay. So, Lata, any questions? So you have so many problems in life now, Lata?
The society fail has the problem, not me.
Okay. Okay. So any question, Namit? Namit, you have a question?
Prabhuji, for example, if there are five children for a parent, is it like they have 15 children? Prabhuji means in Mahabharata, did Kunti had five children? Did she have 50 children?
No. See, actually, in reality, it's like that. But they don't know that. They don't come to this class now, Atmashan class now. They don't know, no?
Yeah. But Kunti means no, Prabhuji. It's common. But
Kunti doesn't know. She doesn't come to Atmashan classes at all. Until you come to Atmashan class, you don't know.
Prabhuji, but in those days it was very common. It was not a special thing, no, Prabhuji.
Yeah, maybe she knows.
Okay.
Okay.
And Prabhuji, in olden days also, was it like we should not tell anyone like we are Atman, or is it about the British history and all, which we should not tell like we are Atman?
No, earlier days, since everybody knows, you can tell. But now nobody knows now. Everybody doesn't know anything now.
Yeah, the Britishers, some people have forgot about their castes.
Yeah. So right now, because the society is like that, you cannot tell.
Yeah. It's situation based.
It's situation based. Correct. Correct. Now, this society child is not one child actually. I told society child is only one. It is not one. It's a whole cell. Sometimes it becomes mother, sometimes it becomes wife, sometimes it becomes woman, sometimes beautiful woman, sometimes young woman. Okay, it's actually wholesale. It's multiple persons packed into one. So it's not even three. It is not even 300. It's not even 3,000. It's much larger. Are you clear?
Gurudeva,
yes, Sheetal.
Gurudeva, when right now the societal child, it has a role in the society.
So much give and take happens in the society.
Not able to hear. What is it?
Yeah, the societal child has so many roles in the society. Yeah. As you said, it is not a one specific thing. There are so many societal imposed roles which it has to play. For example, when we say that. Mm-hmm. Atmano mokshaya jagat hitaya.
Uh-huh.
This is, yeah, this this we have to, like, for the broader betterment of the society, taking context from the divine consciousness, we have to play the role, and we can always remember by playing the role properly that we are the divine child. So how to just join this, Gurudeva, just make it little bit clear. No,
thank no question is not clear.
Yeah,
you have to make the question
clear. Is not Yes, the question is, a societal child has many roles. To play these roles, by keeping the fact that the truth that it's a divine consciousness, how it can be liberated from the clutches of the societal.
Divine child doesn't require liberation from the clutches of society child. Divine child is
no, not the societal child. The societal child.
Oh, okay. Your question is how we play the role of the society child? How I can be still divine child, right?
Yes.
Now how many children you have, Sheetal?
One son.
So when you are talking to me, what is my relationship to you?
I'm talking as an divine consciousness with you. No other relationship.
Yeah. Okay, no other relations.
No.
So, when you are interacting with the society, do you remember that you are a mother of a child anytime? Do you forget that you are a mother of a child anytime?
No, I don't forget.
That's in the background, no?
Yeah.
That's the most important thing, no?
Yeah.
What is most important thing for you? I am the divine child. How can you forget that?
No, I'm not going to forget that. But I want to, use it efficiently when I am playing the role.
That's what I'm saying. If you are divine child, if you remember it, you will be very peaceful in any situation.
I will know that this call has been taken by the divine child. I will know that.
No, I'm saying when you are divine child, you will not be perturbed by the society's turbulence. Your mind will be calm and peaceful. Then your decisions also will be proper.
Yes. Okay, Gurudeva.
Right?
Yeah.
Clear?
Yes, Gurudeva.
Anybody else has a question? Okay. So, did I answer your question or you didn't answer your question?
Prabhuji, I have.
Wait. Yes, Sheetal. Complete the question.
Guruji, 1 minute.
1 minute. Sheetal, complete again.
ನೀವು ಡಿವೈನ್ ಚೈಲ್ಡ್ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೇನು ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಅದನ್ನ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಜ್ಞಾಪಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡು ನೀವು ಇದನ್ನೆಲ್ಲ ಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಮಾಡಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀರಿ. ಅವ್ರು ಕೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನ ಹೇಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ್ಲೂ ಜ್ಞಾಪಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು, ಇದನ್ನ ರೋಲ್ಸ್ ಪ್ಲೇ ಮಾಡಕ್ ಎಫಿಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಗೆ ಜ್ಞಾಪಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಂತ ಅವ್ರು
ಕೇಳ್ತಾರೆ.
Yeah, it is very close. I can say that. Yeah.
So you define the question clearly then.
As I wanted to ask you that, you know, for example, I had to take a call. For example, that, you know, somebody had, I'll give a very specific, you know, I will give an incident without taking any inferences from those. For example, if somebody is traveling in this condition, okay, thinking that, you know, somebody has passed off or something passed away, and you know, this is not a situation, the situation outside does not permit anybody to travel, you know, outside the city. So the societal child in them is, you know, it got woke up in them actually. Then, you know, me knowing that, you know, getting perturbed in this situation is not a way. So the divine consciousness, which says that, you know, the emotions and all right now are, you know, temporary. If they are not addressed and they are told in a very specific way that how, you know, you can just delay the process of even thinking of going there, don't go there. And, you know, when I tell this, I know that this is for the betterment of the society. Then is this role, I am always remembering this, no, Gurudeva. I am telling this because this is for the betterment of the society only, no.
Correct.
I know that. Correct. Yeah, that's what.
So when you are a divine child, your decisions will be more accurate and more uncluttered.
Yeah, so now you understood, right, the question right now. Yeah, so I got the answer. As you said, even Katayani ji has, she understood it very well, as right now she said, ki, you know, when I take a decision based on the betterment of the society, even the societal child is, you know, always reflecting the divine consciousness, a divine child only.
Yeah.
Yes.
So the society child actually should be servant of the divine child.
Yes. Yes, Gurudeva.
Understand? Yes. Normally. But really, yes, society child dominates. A bully dominates.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes, but it should not do like that. It should be very, you know, it should take the inferences from the divine child and it should be firm.
Yeah.
It should not be acting from the world's conditionings.
It should be based on the divine inputs.
Yes, Gurudeva. I got it. Thank you, Gurudeva.
Okay, welcome.
Thank you, Kataniji.
Where is Namit? Namit was asking some question.
Prabhuji here.
Yeah, why?
Prabhuji, does ego come in the group of society child or human child? Does ego comes in the in human child? Does it come in the group of human child or rather what's that? Yeah.
Ego is the society child.
Okay.
Okay. So, shall we complete this?
Practicing. 2 days back, I did that. I practiced that dharana, dhyana, and samadhi.
Okay. Very good. Very good. You understood how to do?
Yeah. It was just like a revision for me.
Oh, okay. Very good. Okay. So let us sit silently for some time and close for the day. So now next week, another 3 videos, or how many videos you want to take next week? So next week again 3 videos.
3 is enough, Guruji.
Okay. Vijay,
how about Kannada class, Guruji? Kannada class.
Kannada class next week, next Friday. So, go through the 3 videos. Lata, you are supposed to do homework. What are you doing?
I will, Prabhuji.
You have to listen to the videos and understand what is there and ask questions.
Yes.
Yes. You always ask wrong questions. Right questions you have to ask.
Yeah.
So, we'll close for the day.
Prabhuji, I have a question.
You have a question, what is that?
For a spiritually realized person, there is no world, right? Then what is the use of following dharma for a spiritually realized person?
For the sake, there is no real world for him.
Yeah.
No real world, please mark my words, real world. There's a virtual world is there.
Okay. So everything is consciousness. For a spiritually realized person, everything is consciousness.
Everything is consciousness, but there's a virtual world. It's as good as a virtual reality.
Hmm.
Okay, and the body is there still. So as long as the body is there, the virtual reality is there, he will do something useful for the society.
Okay. So how does anyone strike a balance between divine child and society child?
So that question is there when you are neither of them, when you are confused, when you are, question is not there. There's no balance. There's always only one child.
Okay.
So we're asking the question from the society child point of view. If you ask the question from divine child point of view, there's no question.
Yes. Yeah. Okay.
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 Okay. Let us sit silently for some time. So, Asatoma Sadgamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnat Purnamuduchate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om Mano Buddhi Ahankara Chitta Aninaham I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, I am not the ego. Nacha Shotra Jivve, Nacha Grana Netre, I am not five sense organs. Now Nacha Vyoma, Bhumirna, Tejona Vayuhu, I am not five elements. Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham, Shivoham. I am pure consciousness, Shiva Swarupi. Name Dvesha Ragav, Name Lobha Mohav. I don't have attraction and repulsion. Mado Naiva, Me Naiva, Matsarya Bhavaha. I don't have jealousy and hatred. Na Dharmo, Na Cha Artho, Na Kamo, Na Mokshaha. Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha are not for me. Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham, Shivoham, I am pure consciousness, Shiva Swarupi. Na Punyam, Na Papam. Na Saukyam, Na Dukkham. Good merit and sin are not for me. Na, I neither happiness nor happiness, unhappiness. Na mantro, na tirtham, na veda, na yadnaha. Mantra, tirtha, veda, yadna are not for me. Aham bhojanam, naiva bhojyam, na bhokta. I am not the experiencer or experienced. Chidananda rupaha, shivoham, Shivoham, I am pure consciousness, Shiva Swarupi. Na Mrityur Na Shanka, Na Me Chati Bedaha, I have no birth, no death. Pita Naiva, Me Naiva, Mata Na Janmaha, I have no father, no mother. Na Bandur Na Mitram, Guru Naiva Shishyam, I don't have friends and relatives, neither Guru nor Shishya. Chidananda Rupaha, Shivoham, Shivoham, I am pure consciousness, Shiva Swarupi. Aham Nirvikalpo, Nirakara Rupo, I am thoughtless and formless. Vibhutvacha, Sarvatra, Sarvendriyanam, I am master of all sense organs. Naja asangatam, naiva muktihi, na meha, I have no attraction, I have no bondage or liberation. Chidananda rupaha, shivoham, shivoham, I am pure consciousness, Shiva Swarupi. So, with that, we'll conclude today's session. So, what is the assignment for next week for you?
Prabhuji, three videos.
And?
And that Ashtavakra Gita.
And
guided meditation.
Daily meditation.
Prabhuji and Shubha Prabhu ji taught me this Nirvanashtakam.
Very good. Very good. Okay, so you'll practice, all of you practice daily meditation?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Okay. Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. It's compulsory.
Okay.
It's possible for all? And Uma Giri Shagata? Time Sigata?
Yes, Guruji.
Aagta ide upayoga agide class?
Khandita aagta ide.
Okay.
Thank you, Guruji.
Huh?
Thank you, Guruji. Upayoga aagtide tumba.
Okay, Gauri. ಗೌರಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮಾತಾಡೇ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಯಾರಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ.
ತುಂಬಾ ಉಪಯೋಗ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಗುರುಜಿ.
ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆಯಾ? ಓಕೆ,
ಎಸ್ ಗುರುಜಿ.
ಆಗುತ್ತಾ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಗುತ್ತಾ? ಇದು
ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀನಿ
ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದು ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ
ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ ಗುರುಜಿ.
ಆಗತ್ತಾ? ಓಕೆ,
ನಿಮ್ದು ಲೈವ್ ಸೆಷನ್.